Now for the homework. First thing you need to do to instantiate the universal image loader is to put it in the base activity. And I'm not going to write it again. In fact, to write it again, I have to search the internet again. So I'll just copy paste it from the template app that we made. And when you copy paste a Java file, it will automatically modify its package name, which is very cool. I will put here internet and external SD card. For caching, okay, and don't forget also to put the name, which I almost forgot. We have it here initialized. Everything looks okay. Now. We get an instance here in the base adapter where we initialize the views. So when we create this main list adapter, we also create an image loader. And very, very simple. It's image loader display image, and I choose the second one because it also gives me the option to put some display options here, which I want to, because I want them like this in case I. Like I told you, if you want rounded images or to play a little with, I don't know, some configurations, it will be easier after. So first I need to put, you press Ctrl P to get all the list of information. So I need a URL for the image, which is picture URL. Second parameter is the image view, which is folder image view of picture, and the third parameter is the options, which are this. Let's go ahead and test it to see if it works. Now this image is on the emulators, they load very slowly. But here they load. Okay, I see. Okay, so here you go. Now I hope you enjoyed this this free course, and I invite you to take the second one, which is paid, and in the second series of this tutorial we're going to talk about parsing JSON, data persistence, and how we can store data in our application. I'm gonna show you how to create endless list views that automatically load data into them from an infinite adapter, and also swipe to refresh for example how it looks in the Gmail app, and I'm going to talk about services and how to update your app. For example, you can use services to create a weather application, or you can use services to send the location of the user, for example, to a server every 10 minutes and much more, or to play a music in the background. there's a lot of usages. Second, I'm going to make with you step by step an application that I saw that was given at a job interview, and you should be able to do it by yourself, but I'm going to do it together with you. Then we will talk about app settings and how to create a settings activity. It's very easy to do. I'll just show you. I will make with you step by step a music application that plays some MP3s from the internet, and then we will modify this application to be a radio application. After that, an app that plays a shows a TV stream, and after that, how to get user location coordinates. Then simple animation and how nice transitions, like I don't know, fade in, swipe left. After that, a big lesson about styling your application, how to use custom fonts and more, how to style your application to look good. Then another big lesson, tips and tricks about publishing your app. It's not, and what you should be careful when you publish your app. And I forgot to add this, I will add now security. Also a lesson about security and how can you protect your app from getting its code stolen and stuff. A very nice lesson about how to make money with your app, what are the best methods, where you should put the ads, how are Google terms when you put the ads, because you have to respect some guidelines when you do this. So I will talk about them in this lesson, and much more if I have other ideas and I see the subject is trending, I will make a lesson for it. So I hope I will see you in the second part of this series, and good luck with your apps. If you have any feedback for this course or questions, please feel free to comment